Yes, remember.
Okay, once again, Shantabhi. Today I will indexing and slicing we have seen, and the next program we will see. Once again, wait, he is on the way. I am just waiting for him. We will see that whole thing. Once again, someone is calling. Hello? Yeah, okay. Okay, I will record the video also. You are facing some network problem, right? You are in hometown? In your hometown? Okay. Yeah, okay. Okay. Hello? This is ndim, that means finding the dimensions onto this. Okay, we will see. Okay, he will join within 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, we will see the class. Indexing and slicing. In indexing and slicing, we are going to see about the np dot random of rand int of 10, 115. Okay, between the 10 to 100, the 15 values. Okay, 15 values there. 5 threes are 15. Okay, we are reshaping three row, 5 columns. Okay, we are making like this. Okay, which has the three element, three rows and 5 column. Able to understand this? This is np dot random dot rand int. Okay, 10 to 100 means, which is between the 10 to 100, there is a 15 values. Okay, I'm just reshaping into 3, 5. So it will have the 15 values. Okay, inside this array. Able to understand this? Okay.
Yes, we will.
Okay, I will show you the double indexing. Okay, the mat 1 of 2 means, 1 means the first one. Okay. In the first one, there is a take, it's taking, I will show, take a note, okay. Okay, this is a thing, one means, this is zero. This is one. Okay, one second. Yeah, this is zero, this is one. One means, it taking the, this list. Taking a note, this list, it is taking this list. Okay, in this list it taking the second value, that means this is zero, this is one, this is two, which mean be the 56. Okay, the value is 56. Okay, able to understand? The one means inside this list it finding the another list. This is a 0, this is a 1, which is a 1, this list, and in this indexing 0, 1, 2 means it will be a 56 value. Okay, every time start from 0, 1. Okay, and we can use like this also. Both are similar things. Okay, you able to understand this?
Yes, remember.
Okay, here the entire row at index 2. Okay, if suppose I'm applying this, means what will be the answer you are thinking? Anyone from this?
Last row.
Yeah, it's a it will give the last row. It's correct. It will produce the last row. Right, if it is, this means what the value will be, colon comma 3 for this. This is a row, mentioning the row. The colon colon is mentioning the row. So we have to take three row and a third column, which will produce this value. Yeah, I will show you. This will produce a only which is 39, okay. 39, 49, 58. This is this one. Okay. And this is 92, 89, 92. This one, sorry, 0, 1, 2, 3. That means entire row, this determining the entire row, okay? Should taking the entire row, this will be the row, okay? This will be the row. Taking the entire row, first one is mentioning the entire row, taking entire row. Second one is mentioning the 3, that means the column 0, 1, 2, 3. So it's producing a value 92, 89, 92. Able to understand this? Otherwise I will explain once again. Hello? I will do answer.
Well, it's why it shows flatten.
Yeah, actually it's showing the flatten because it's taking only this value, which is similar like taking some values. Okay, it will not show like this. If suppose we should convert it into like this, means we have to dot reshape of -1, 1. Okay, it will take this value only, this 92 89 92, and it's producing one list. It will produce values like if suppose a colon comma colon, means which will take the entire row, okay, entire column, okay. If suppose I am changing that little bit, means the value will get shrink. Okay, I will give some answer.
So can we use this colon instead of ravel to flatten?
Yeah, we can use that. Instead of ravel, we cannot use this. Actually, this is for a thing like I will show with some Handson. Okay, where is the answer? I will show with some Handson. Okay, here I'm just taking data equal to import numpy. Okay, here I'm just taking the 50, okay, 50 dot reshape of 2, 25, which have the 50 values is reshaped into 2 of 25 values. Okay, here we have the size up to 6 values. Okay, if we see, means we can find that it is as a 6 values. So I'm just going to use size to find the size. Okay, I can use the ndim. Ndim means dot ndim for finding the how much dimension it is, and we can use the shape. Okay, it is a 2, 3. Now I'm going to reshape into 3, 2. Okay, now it is resized. Actually, this values are become, sorry, the first value, the 44, 94, it is the first value. 24 and 88 will be second value. 93 and 11 will be third value. Able to understand this? Actually, you can able to do a lot of things like, if you want only I need up to this value. Okay, 88, 93, 11 means I can use 1 here. 88, 93, 11. Able to understand this? How the indexing is working? This is 0, this is a 1, this is a row. First one is row, this is a column. Which have the row values, okay? Actually, this can be used for like, while you are seeing the data, you should understand that how the data, in which for which dimensions, okay? Actually, if you are working with a lot of images, okay, for predicting the images, like cat or dog, okay? If you try to predict the images, whether it is a cat or dog, okay, you will have the images of cat 10,000. Okay. Which is already I have shown that how to convert the images into IMShow. Using IMShow, I converted it into lot of arrays before OpenCV. Okay. Likewise, we can convert the images into lot of matrices, okay, which have the data, okay. After that, we can apply that number to machine learning model, okay, machine learning model, which will statistically adjust itself, okay, which is statistically adjust itself, and which is statistically adjust itself, and after that, it will build the model. From lot of images, our model get trained. Okay, lot of numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Lot of things. Before that, we have to do lot of things. I'm explaining. But this number, everything is, if it is, already I have told that I have some values, okay, like 6, 4, 3. Okay, if it is a 6 means it is 5, okay, it is a 5, it is 3, it is 2. How it exactly happened means this is a minus 1, the value produced, this value is produced by minus 1, this value is produced by minus 1. I am just to inside the machine learning model, okay, as an input, this can be a output, okay, there will be like some statistics thing happening, okay, automatically get adjust based on the data, it will automatically get adjust, okay. After that, I am passing the 5 means, after training, this is a training, after passing the data, okay, which will do the back propagation, everything. After that, I'm just, after training, I will pitch this 5 value. 5 value means it will predict that 4 because of this thing. Okay. Similar like I will have the cat images. Okay. I will label it. I will have the cat images in one side of the model and the dog images, lot of dog images. Also, I am just having, okay. I will label this as a cat as output. Okay. I will label this as a dog in the output. Okay. Okay. This is a cat. This is a dog I labeled. So from this images, some number of matrices, it will able to, our model will get trained from this data, okay, it will get adjust, it will get adjust, and it will have some predictive, some kind of math data. I will tell that, okay. Actually, this will be full of numbers, okay. This images, don't see it as images, it is having a lot of numbers. We have already seen in IMShow, cv2.imshow. If I passing the cv2.imshow inside the images, means it will convert it into array. Similar like we can convert the images into array. I'm just passing into machine learning algorithms. I'm label it as a cat. Similar like this. It is an input which have output. This is the input. This is the output. This is the input, output. This is the input, output. So I'm just having this after passing a new value means it able to find 4. Okay. Similar like if I passing the new images inside the model means, okay, it will, it based on the numbers and everything, okay, it will predict the, try to predict the cat. Or if I'm passing dog means it will predict the dog. If suppose I'm passing the human image inside this model means, what will it will do means, based on this, based on this number, okay, okay, based on this number, okay, based on this number, which is closely related, okay, which is closely related to cat or dog, it will see that human. If it is a cat means it will say cat. It will be a dog means it will say dog. Okay, able to understand this? Hello, this is little bit.
So Vimal, a different, like in this example, different cat or dog images have similar kind of matrices values, and that's why model will be able to predict, right?
Yeah, it is actually based on the, if a cat means, okay, the cat will have some ear like this, okay, cat will have ear like this, it will be like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or something based on the darkness. Okay, dog will have the ear like this. Okay, we have training with a lot of images. Okay, we are training with a lot of images, so we have the output also. If suppose back propagation means what I will say, okay, the thing back propagation means, okay, I am doing the first thing. Okay, first thing is right, second thing is wrong, okay, third thing is, sorry, first thing is right, second thing is right, third thing is wrong means it will go again back to the one. So it will try to adjust it and go to second one, third one, fourth one is right, fifth one is right, sixth one is wrong means it will go again back to the this value and try to adjust itself. This is happening inside while this is a model, while input is going inside, okay, output is there, okay, our value will be gone inside, okay, it will hit the value. Input is the cat, I'm having a cat label here, this is a dog value here, okay, it will hit down the cat and it will back propagate again. The another image will go and it don't and back propagate, it don't back propagate, it don't back propagate. So what happened means it will get adjust. While I'm training with a lot of cat images, it will get adjust, model is get adjust based on the numbers. That is a statistics. Okay, and same I'm doing with dog, it go and eat and come back, go and eat, come back, go and eat, come back. This is called back propagate, which is adjusting itself. Able to understand now? Actually now the model will be get built after training with the data, so it will be some statistics value. After that I'm moving the new picture, okay, of cat, that will automatically go into cat. If it is a dog means it will automatically go into dog based on the adjusted statistics. Before that we have trained with the data. Okay, this is actually data science. Able to understand? Actually not for this only, not for this is a classification problem, not for this only, there is a another kind of thing is also there. Okay, if I'm buying the Google stock, today is a, actually nowadays the Google stock is $1,500, which is equal to 85,000. Okay, tomorrow if someone is investing on this thing, okay, tomorrow I'm just getting the all the old data of Google stock price, and I can able to predict the future Google stock price how much the value will be based on the history data. Like similar like cat image, we will get that. This is actually a regression problem, which is continuously changing the value. You able to understand this? Any doubt? It will be a little bit complicated, and after putting code, it is very easy actually. The thing is,
so like in regression problem in this stock price. So how do we get to know that these particular attributes impact the final outcome? I mean, which inputs we need to consider, or which needs to be, I mean, ignored like that?
Yeah, actually, if suppose I'm having a data frame, okay, of diabetes, okay, diabetes data set, there is one package already. That is that you ask the question, that is called future extraction. Okay, future extraction. I will take that in future. Okay, the future extraction and pre-processing, future extraction, bagging, boosting algorithms. Okay, the future extraction means I'm just having the diabetes data set. Okay, I'm just having the lot of data like age, gender, everything. This is the age. This is a gender. Sorry, this is a gender. This is age. Okay, this is the blood glucose level. This is the diabetes, whether they are having or not. Okay, diabetes, whether they are having or not. This is a serial number. Okay, if suppose the gender is male and female, okay, and age, some age will also somewhat impact that whether they will have the diabetes. 40, 35, okay, and this is the glucose level, okay, the glucose level 90. Yes. Okay. If suppose I'm applying the future extraction, there is a package called GREF. Okay. And another one is PCA. Principal compound analysis. This will create an impact. Like while we are going in depth, I will tell you. Okay, like this thing. While applying this thing, okay, to this value, which will create which will find the significant value. Okay, here the diabetes is caused because of thing. The glucose level here, the glucose, because of 82 above 80 blood glucose level will be sugar, which will create a significant to the output. This is a significant value. While we are applying the PCA, okay, we can rank, which is this is also one of the impact. Okay, the glucose level, and another one is age. If they having age above 40 or 35, they will have sugar. Okay, these both the things will significant. While I am applying the PCA over here, okay, to this data frame, it will automatically say that this thing is correlated to this one. This thing is correlated to this one. Okay, able to understand now? This is a future.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
This is a future extraction. We can use a PCA to find the which are the columns are significant. Actually, if suppose some columns are null values, filled with a lot of null values, means we have to fill with some average values. Okay. Otherwise, we can do another thing is there is an imputer package which will remove the null values. Okay. And imputer form, it will make an average, and we can. If it is a lot of null values, means we can drop that column also. Okay. actually we cannot, the null value is a main problem will cause. Okay, you able to understand that up to this?
Yes ma'am.
Up to this able to understand everyone?
Yes ma'am.
Okay. Here we taken the first, only the first value, this one. Okay, if suppose I'm taking complete value, which will produce the two values. Okay, actually this one. Okay, so only we are going, if suppose I'm giving 1, 2 means why it is producing 8 means, okay, the first row is the first row and second value which is a 8, so only it is a similar like that value. Okay, able to understand now why it is happened? Hello.
Yes ma'am.
Actually this is a 0 and 1. Okay, 0, 1, 2. Okay, this is a first value and it is a 0, 1, 2. Second value is 8, so only it causes a value like one, similar like 1:2. Similar like this, because of this thing only. Yeah, we are using the 1, 2 for entering into the 56. Both the things are similar, 1:2. And the next thing is entire row at index of 2. Of 2 means the second value completely. 3 means 0, 1, 2, 3. This value we will completely take. Okay. Here 1:3 means we can find that row, 3 row. First 1, 2, 3 row. This is a 0. 0 is not there. 1, 2. That means a 2 row. And the 3:5 means 0, 1, 2, 3. 3 to 5 means up to 89, 93, 92, 63. Okay. I will, this is able to understand. Actually 1:3 means which is significant the row. Okay, 1:3. That means row, first to see the row, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, which is a row. Here 1 is this one. 3 means up to 3 means it will take 2 value. We have already, the Python is like that only. If you are putting 4 means it will take up to 3 values. You know that everyone? Hello?
Yes, Vimal.
Okay. Here 1:3 means which is a 91, 94, 56, 89, 93, 39, 49, 58, 92, 63. Okay, this 2 row it is taking. Okay, and 3:5 is column 0, 1, 2, 3. That means 89 to 55. Okay, up to this. That is up to 4. This is a 3, 4, 5. It won't take up to 4. We're taking this value. Okay, the 0:2 means, just to see that, 0, 1, 2. Okay, it will take only the first 2 values. Okay, 1:3 means, 1:3 means, which is a, which is 1, 1:3 means, 0:3, 1:3 means, here the value, the after taking this value, applying 1:3, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, that means 12, 21, 94, 56. Okay, what happened? 1292. Yeah, okay. It is indexing directly, not a semicolon. I've just comma 3 means just taking the that already we have seen that subset. Subset means which will directly notify that value. Okay, where is that subset? I will just show with the answer. Where is the answer? Here is a subset. I will show you what is meant by that. Okay, 1, 2. Sorry, I have to give something. Okay, that means the first value and second value we are getting. Okay, if suppose I just want 8 means the 8th value we will get. Actually, this is not impacting the row and column. Okay, which will open extra means the I'm just taking one array. Okay, here I'm going to it will produce a full value, but in here I just need only 1 and 2 of 1 and 2 both value. Okay, similar like just out of round of range. Be similar like it's similar like this one, both things are same. But it takes that value of subset of that value. Able to understand this? Actually taking the 6 and 7. Hello? Able to understand this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it is a 6 and 7. You're taking the directly indexing that value. Okay, yesterday I just programmed in another laptop. I just take only one list, one equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, how can I now directly index the two values means colon. Slice must be an integer, not a list. For this, sorry, I have to convert it into np dot array. Okay, this is a direct indexing. Okay, while we are using list means, in the list you cannot apply the this one. List one equal to 4. Okay, here I'm just trying, because it is actually array, that is not an array. This is a list 1, 2. It will show the error. Okay, but while you are applying 1, 2 means it will directly indexing the value 2, 3. Hello, able to understand this?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, this one. We are same. We are using 0, 2 and 1, 3 means 0, 2. Okay, 0, 2 is 0, 2, 1, 2. That means the two value and 0, 1, 1294, 2, 3, 9, 2, 89. Okay, which will produce a value like this. Able to understand? We will go to next one. Hello. Shall we go to next one or any doubt?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. And conditional subsetting. Okay. This will also nice. Okay. Actually, we can in the list you cannot do like this. Okay. Okay. In list you cannot directly apply the conditions inside that value. Okay, but while I'm using this one, we can directly apply the condition. Sorry, import dot. I'm just doing not imported numpy. Okay. It is that. From 10 to 100, taking the 15 value, which is reshaped to 3, 5, which is a multiply of this value. There is a 3 row and 5 column. Okay. And after that, we are just getting only the element greater than 50. I'm just passing this value. For this, I will show you some Handson also. Okay. Array 1 equal to. Here I'm just going to array 1. Okay, this is called a conditional subsetting. Okay, based on some condition we can subset. Okay, if suppose we need even number of from this means. Okay, able to understand this one? This is a conditional subsetting. We can do this. Actually, while you are in list, you cannot do anything. Okay, while you are using NumPy, you can do a lot of things. Okay, so only we are converting into NumPy. The thing is, why we actually for machine learning part lot, we don't need to use a lot of things, but you are using some advanced data. Like banking setup, financial data. Okay, you are working in your office or something means you should know somewhat about this. Okay. Hello, able to understand this? Conditional subsetting.
Yes. Yes. Vimal, I have one question. Here we have two dimensional array.
Yeah.
No, in the NumPy. No. Yes. It is a two dimensional array, right?
Yeah.
MIT. And output is one dimensional.
This one. Yeah. Actually, after applying this value, okay, which will impact all the values. It have the condition to take all the values into Ravel.
Okay.
It have the condition like that only. Similar like.
So it will Ravel the array automatically.
Yeah, it will. It is a similar like. Okay, similar like. Mat colon comma colon 4. Okay, it is similar like this. I'm just taking the last value 54, 17, 15. From all the list, it is taking the value. Okay, 54, 17, 15. It is a similar like that. It is taking all the values.
Okay, got it.
Okay.
So Vimal, I have a question here.
Okay.
So actually every time we are using np.random.randint, right?
Yeah.
So every time it will return a random number, I mean the different number whenever we will run this code. So is there any way to use the same code, like the fix this code and we will get the same matrix every time?
What?
So is there is any way in our NumPy to fix this part, like we will get the same number every time?
Yeah, there is a possible that np.seal.
Okay.
Which will... Once again, np.random.seal. Okay. Should produce a different values. np.random.seal, which we can use it to reproduce, stop the reproduce of value. Where is the np.random.seed? We can use this np.random.seed.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. This method is actually the random state is initialized, it can called again to re-see the generator. That means it will stop that the value get again the producing. Okay, for that I think here also okay, sorry, I will just use it before this. Okay, 96.15. Once again, I will restart the kernel.
Okay.
I have already done this. Which will have the 39.55. Here I should use dot seed. Here, no. I think I have done in this so far. Stop the random. Control F. One second. I will just I done that. Bunch of random suppression. Okay, we should pass 0, I think. Okay. Yeah, it's okay. I have worked with that, but after now I'm just working with unstructured data. But I know the seed, I have just used it before. The seed is answer. Where is that output? Two digit conditional subsetting. Okay. Here I'm just going to use ANT dot random dot seed. Okay. This will be a stable value. Okay.
Okay.
Are you able to understand this one? Actually, the 0, 1 means
I think 0 and 1 are working the same.
Yeah, 0 and 1 are working same. I think the default value is none, so only it's not working before. There is a default value which is none, okay? Okay, able to understand this?
Yes, ma'am.
So what is the mean?
Yeah, actually,
what is the meaning of this 0 and 1?
This will control. Actually, generator means we have already see that generator which will control the which can be used in data structures for controlling the data. Okay, for controlling like iterations. Okay, I can control the iteration. I can take the each time one values from the things. Okay. Likewise, the np.random.seed, which will stop the random, okay, which will stop the random to stable in that, to stable in that value. Okay, we can use that. This is a kind of iterations. It's a 0 and 1 is actually the 0 and 1, the both are similar, which are seeding the value same.
Okay, so we will the value it. Which we are okay. Yeah. Actually, so with the different seed number, we are getting different numbers.
No. Actually, the different the seed is just an iterations. Like after third iteration, after fourth iteration, what will happen? Okay, similar like this. The seed, which will be the iteration of after third value, what we will get if it run means. How can I say means after I found it actually 5 after under duration the value get changed, it will produce a different values. If 50 means after 50 duration we will get this random value. Okay, after 25 iteration means, but it will be same, okay, which will controlling the iteration. After the 25 iteration, what will be the value? After 80 iteration, the value will be like this. 57, 70, it will produce a value like this. I'm running same thing, 80. The value will not change. Able to understand this? Actually, how much iteration time? Actually, zero means the first iteration itself, zero. Okay, the one means after second iteration, the
okay.
How the value is changing, we will see that in zero we are getting 54, 57, okay, 71. During first iteration, the value changes like this. Sorry, third iteration, value changes like this. Okay. It's similar.
Okay.
Actually, it is controlling the iteration. The random value, if suppose we don't have this value, means 24, 36. Second time I'm running 53, 43. Okay. Next time I'm running 47, 66. Okay. Hello, able to understand this? Hello?
Yes.
Everyone understand this? How it's working?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Next thing is okay. The next thing is array operation. Okay. Array operation which have array hyphen array. Okay, here the array operation, the random value of 1 to 10, there is a 9 values, and 1 to 10, 9 values, which I'm reshaping into 3,3 and 3,3, which will be the 9 values is reshaped into 3 dimension 3 3 colon sorry 3 row 3 matrix sorry 3 row 3 column 3 row 3 column. Okay, after that we are first thing we are having the value like this. Okay, after that we are doing the addition. Okay, we are doing the addition, we are doing the multiplication, we after that we are doing the division. Actually, someone asked that why it is in float dot zero means while we are doing a division means it will be default value will be a float. Okay, and we can do a lot of operations like 3 into A minus 2 into B. It is an equation. For that also it will producing value. And addition of 100. adding 100 means 100 plus. I'm adding 100 plus means which will add to each and every element. Okay. Which will add to each and every element. And if suppose I'm using mat 1 into 3 means which is a which applies the power to power cube to each and every elements, 1 power cube and here 4 power, not 4, this is a cube. After applying this square root 0.1, that is a very less, that is similar to 1/2, that means a square root, right? Actually this thing is square root. 0.5 means 1/2, 1/2 means like this one. 4 power 1/2 is 2, which is similar to square root.
Yes, the square root.
Yeah, so it is producing a 2. Okay, here we are applying the power directly to this, to this value and 1 and directly we are applying this. This is 125. This is 125. Sorry, 225. This will be 18 into 6. This will be 108. Okay. Likewise, we can do all the things like power the things, and we are using the square root. And we are adding the values and we are using some equations and we are just using the divide. Okay, divide means it will produce some values like in float. Actually, why we are doing all these things means this is a basic things. Okay, this is a basic things to build an big thing. Okay, actually if suppose these questions may be actually machine learning, the thing is already all the packages are inbuilt nowadays. As in sklearn you can do all the things, using sklearn you can do all the things from pre-processing some to all the things you can do using sklearn. But the thing, these are you are learning because the thing is, if suppose just someone asking you to, okay, someone asking you, not in office, they won't ask like this. So someone asking you to build a new algorithm, I am having a idea for the new algorithm, just to build a code for it. Okay, if suppose someone giving to you means actually you know this math stuff means, okay, you can able to build. Okay, but it will take some time to build. Okay, able to understand this? Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next one is, this is the first matrix, this is the second matrix, and addition, multiplication, division, linear combination, okay, addition of scalar, and we are using matrix cube, and the next thing is we are going to use VStack. Okay, VStack is nothing but, while we are using VStack, the value will be suppose I'm applying the VStack over here means it is a, this is a 1, 2 and 3, 4.